So today we're going to learn how to creating the table using datasheet view and how to creating the table using the design view. Okay. So first creating table using datasheet view. Okay. So when we start with the new database, the access provide you a new blank table. Okay. This is the table one. Okay. And this is our open datasheet view. So you can add the field in this table as per your requirement and feed the data in this database view. So if you want to create another table in the database, you have to just here close the table one and click on the create tab. In the create tab, the table groups here, choose the table option. Immediately one table will be created. Okay. So Access gives a default field in our table. Name is the ID, okay? And it's having the type of auto number which generate the unique values for the field of during the data entry in this way. Look at here. The automatically the unique number will be entered. So also if you want to rename this field, double click on this field header, okay, and just erase it and give a suitable name, student ID, in this way. So in this way you can also change the data type and also formatting in this data sheet. Okay, so look at here in the data sheet tab, the one group here, data type and formatting. Okay, so look at here the data type. When we click on their drop down button, here the number of fields: text, memo, numbers, date and time, currency, yes, no. Okay, so if you want to one number field, okay, this is our number field, so write the field name number. Okay, so also if you want to add one yes no field, look at here in this way, yes no. Okay, in this way you can add a multiple fields and also the format. Okay, means the currency, euros, okay, number in the form of which format, yes no in the form of which format, true false, yes no, on off. Okay, in this way. First, to add the new field in the datasheet view, okay, so firstly, so look at here, this is our ID, this is your unique by default present field. Okay, so if you want to rename this, double click on this and write the suitable name. Okay, then so adding the new sheet, click on the new field, add, look at here in the data type and formatting group, here one option data type, click on the drop down button and choose the text. Also if you want to add another field, select it, click on the data type tab, date and time, again select it, number. Okay, in this way you can add the new field. Also if you want to rename this field, double click on it, erase it and gives a suitable name, student name, then DOB. Mobile number. Okay, in this way. So here write the first name, next unknown, So look at here, immediately the student ID is one unique number is added, Rashmi, then Rohan, in this way. Date of birth 1/10/96, then 3/10/96, then 4. Okay, then the mobile number. So in this way we creating a table. So if you want to create another one table, so click on the file tab, choose the save as option and save as a object. Here type the save the first table name student. Okay, so look at here, the table 1 is created. So if you add one more another table, so here just click on the create button, table, this is the table 2 is created. Okay, in this way, look at here in the navigation panel, its newly created table will be listed in, okay, under the table group. So in this way you can add a new field in our data sheet view. Okay, next is the modifying table. The modifying tables means once the table is created, it can always be modified as per the changes needed of the database. Means you can add a new field, you can delete unwanted field, you can change the field name, etc. So first, how to add a new field? In this way, okay, since this is our student name, so I want to add here the one new field. Just select it, right click and insert the column. Look at here, the one new field will be added here. Rename roll number. Okay, in this way. Okay, next, deleted the unwanted fields. So if you want to delete any field from this table, just right click on their header field and look at here, one option is delete column. When we click here, they gives one notification box. Do you want to permanently delete this selected field? Okay, so when I click yes, this field is deleted. Look at here, in this way. So next is rename the field name. Okay, so in the datasheet view, if you want to rename this field name, just click the right click in the field header and look at here, one option is rename the column. Click on the rename column option, erase it and give a suitable name. In this way. Also, you can double click on it and change this field name in this way. Double click it, erase it and dupe in this way. Okay, means two way we can rename the field name. So in this way we can add a new field, also we can delete the unwanted field and also rename the field name. Okay, so So now we're going to study how to creating the table using design view. So let's start. Means you can also use the design view to create a new customized table. Okay. So first click on the create tab. In the create tab, look at here the table group here and choose the table design option in this way. Immediately a new blank table will be appear in a design view. Okay. And a new tab name is a, look at here, the design tab appear in the ribbon. Okay, so here the view, tools, hide and show, and also in the table design view three fields of column here, first field name, data type and description. First select the first cell, okay, the field name column, and enter some name in this way. So roll number, tab it. So roll number, select the data type there, auto number. Next the description, student. Roll number. Okay, then next field is student name. Okay, choose the data type, text, name of the student, then the term one. Choose the data type, number, term first, marks, then term. Choose the data type, number, term second, marks, and last grade. Choose the data type, text, next student grade. Okay, in this way we can write the field name, data type and their description. Okay, so when this whole data is completed, just click on the file tab. In the file tab, save as option here, choose the save object as, write the table name, student second. When we click this OK button, immediately one dialog box will be appear here. There is no primary key defined. So look at it in the tools group, the primary key option here. So what is meant by primary key and how to adding this primary key? So first, primary key is the field or the combination of field, okay, in the table, which helps to identify each record uniquely in the table. For example, the roll number. So look at it, this roll number field, okay. This roll number field in the student table helps to identify the each student with their unique roll number assigned to each one of them. Okay, means a primary key field never accept a duplicate value and it's never accept the empty or null value. Just select this field that you want to use as a primary key. Okay, so I select this one key, roll number. Just right click on their path and look at here, your option, the primary key. Okay, also in another way, add the primary key. Just select this field and look at here in the tool group, the primary key option here. So choose it. Okay, so look at here, the immediately, so in the row selected of this area, okay, marking it as a primary key. So just save this So in this way you can creating the table using the design view. Look at here, this is our table, and in this way you have to add the data: student name, term 1, term 2 marks and the grades. Okay. So in the next video we are going to study how to creating the forms, how to creating the queries and how to creating the reports. Okay, so thank you student watching this video very carefully. If you like my video, so subscribe my channel and press the bell icon, means my new uploaded video gives a notification to you. Thank you all dear student.